If you own a laser, you've been here. You spend half an hour aligning your laser with your project. You finally think you've got it right. You hit start, and then a few minutes later, your piece comes out looking like this. Today, we're here to fix that. I'm going to teach you how I get items perfectly aligned to be etched every single time. With about 20 minutes of work, we'll build a setup to ensure that never happens to you again. And stick around to the end of the video to hear my helpful tips on how to use it. So there's two key aspects of getting a perfect alignment. The first is to ensure your laser is in a reproducible position, and the second is ensuring your object is aligned with your setup every time. So we need to build something that guides both our laser to the same spot and our object positioned under the laser appropriately. So to do this, we're gonna build an alignment jig, and it's more simple than you think. Here's the materials you're going to need. I used 1/4-inch plywood. You may wanna go thicker if you have a more powerful laser. We'll need whatever laser etcher you're using. And finally, we'll need a bottle of wood glue. I'm using Tight Bond 2 here. The first step in the process is going to be to cut the plywood for your working surface. You need to cut it bigger than the footprint of your laser by 2 to 3 centimeters in each direction. The laser I'm using is the Latitool F50. It has an etching range of 410 millimeters by 410 millimeters, but a footprint of 52 centimeters by 57 centimeters. So, since my laser is 52 by 57, we're going to cut it at 54 by 60. After we get the base cut out, we're going to cut foot holders. These will just be small, 1 centimeter wide by 5 centimeter long pieces. We'll need about 8 of those. Let's move on to assembly. We'll start in one corner of our plywood and glue up 2 pieces just like this. This should allow the feet of your laser to sit flush against the stops. Wait for those to dry. Now, move to an adjacent corner and repeat the process. Start by just gluing up one of these sides and let that dry. After that, get your laser set on there so you can align the 4th piece right up against the foot. Make sure when you're gluing it that you remove your laser after you glue, that way it doesn't get glued to the board. I only ended up gluing these in 3 of the 4 corners here. Gluing up the last might over-constrain your system and make it difficult for your laser to fit on the board. Now we'll wait for the glue to set. So once the glue is dry, we've completed the first phase of getting a reproducible laser setup. Now we can move on to getting a repeatable object placement system. Start by positioning your laser on your setup. I like to drag mine down to the bottom left corner. We're going to use the laser to etch a grid onto the surface of the plywood. So now we need a grid to etch onto the surface. I built this 1 centimeter square grid in Google Sheets. It's 40 by 40. To match my laser setup of 41 by 41 with a little bit of buffer. I brought that file into Laser GBRL and set the dimensions at 400 millimeters by 400 millimeters. Once that's ready, we can hit start and let the laser do the work. And a little while later, this is the finished product. So you can see now I have a grid of 40 by 40 that I can use to align my projects. So now that we have our jig built, let's put it to the test. It takes 3 steps to use. First, put your laser against the locating feet. Next, set the home position on one of the intersections of the grid. I like to trace a square outline of my project at this point to ensure it aligns with the grid in each direction. Finally, place your object. I've got a 9 by 9 centimeter square piece of cedar here that I'm going to turn into a coaster as a souvenir from a recent vacation. So I just align that with the grid, and once I'm satisfied, I'll hit start.
All right, laser just finished etching. Let's check out the alignment. So, now that I'm looking at this, I probably should have chosen a different photo for this demonstration on alignment.
All right, take 2, and here's the final result. As you can see, everything is perfectly aligned, and it was quick and easy now that I have this jig. So that's it, guys. I hope you found this video helpful. Now get out there, give this a shot, and let me know how it goes in the comments below.